In this video, I wanted to show you a simple and easy way that you can warp your text for t-shirt designs or any design that you're doing. You can do this all online for free, and I'll show you how to do it. Let's go. Thanks for joining me on this video. My name is Juna with Detour Shirts. I've been designing and selling t-shirts online since 2005. And in this video, I wanted to show you some techniques that I've just learned recently, and that is warping text with an app online called Photopea. I've talked about this app before, Photopea. It's really powerful and it's totally free. And the two apps that I mostly talk about on this channel is Canva and Affinity Designer. Well, one of the drawbacks of those two is that you can't really warp text easily, but don't worry, Photopea can help you out with it and it can warp text really easily. So you can use Canva and or Affinity Designer with Photopea to warp text. I'll show you how to do that. You can actually warp text within Photopea on its own. You don't need to use Canva or Affinity Designer, but if you have some special fonts or special things that you like to use in Canva or Affinity Designer, you can actually bring those in. So I'm gonna show you how to do it just with Photopea first, and then I'm gonna show you how you can integrate Canva and Affinity Designer with Photopea to do those warping styles. So let's get into Photopea right now. So here we are on Photopea, or some people call it Photopea. I think it's Photopea actually, but you can see here, photopea.com. You just go to there. The reason why it's free is because there's all these ads right here. So just don't pay attention to those. What we're gonna do is start right here. You can see it's integrated with some of these apps right here. Affinity Designer and Canva are not one of them, but you can integrate or import any JPEG, PNG, TIFF, whatever. So it's super powerful that way. We're just gonna start a new project. So I'm gonna do that. And then we're gonna do 4,500 by 5,400 here, the Amazon size, or at least the size that they used to want. And then we're just hit create. All right, so we have our size right here. The first thing we're gonna do is type some text in here. We'll just do something like that. And let's pick a font that we like. One of the fonts that I like is Chango. So that's Chango. Boom. Okay, and then let's type something. P. Okay, we got love right there. And let's make it bigger. I believe you can just do this. Or type in, you know, 300. Boom. Whatever size it is, we can move this around and make it bigger. Let's see. Let's make this a lot bigger here. Maybe 600. All right. Now this is just to show you the different warping things that you have on here. So we'll go to text. Make sure it's that big. So now that we have our text here, we can go to warp right here. You may have not seen this, but it's always here for text. And you can see all the different styles if you click on here, all the different styles. So let's try a few of them. You see you got arc, just really quick. And then you got some of these handles that you can adjust. So this is basically what Canva has, is this thing. But Canva doesn't have this kind of distort. See that? And vertical distort. So we can try that, or we can try upper lower arc. Actually, let's remove that. Let's do it again. Let's try something else. This kind of arc, which you can play with. Isn't that cool? I love this one. You could also do vertical distort. There's some other cool ones. The one that I really like is arc. So let's stop this and do it again. So let's try warp again and do arc. And so this one's a little different because you can see that it's straight right here instead of the arc this way. So there's arc and then the arch, right? See how that one, this is kind of what Canva does, but this is kind of what you probably would want to do for like a athletic thing. And then you got flag here. Look at that. Some cool one. Wave is a really good one if you have multiple words, and I'll show you that. I'll type in some more words. But fish and rise and just a whole bunch of all of these. So really quick. And of course, you can make these bigger too. So if you want, once you're done with it, let's say, yes, I like that. You can come in here and it's still editable text. So if you wanna change it to something else, you can. Or if you want to make it bigger, you can, you know, maybe it's 800 pixels. Boom. So still editable, still fun, like that. So let's try a multiple words. I'm going to get rid of this text here. And let's do this again. Gonna fill the space. Love, inspire, teach. Maybe a smaller word. Love, help, teach. Okay, and then let's make this centered. And let's do the warp again, but let's try this wave. See that? Now you can move things around. It's very simple to do the wave. And there you go. And then you can lock it in. How easy was that? That was super easy. And you can change the things too. So try wave, try different things. So play around with that. I'm going to show you how to do this with Canva and Affinity Designer. Let's say you have a font that you want. Actually, if you have a font that you want and you know you found it like on the font or something, you can actually load a font. So let me show you how to do that. I'm going to get rid of this text. And we're going to type in another text here. So when you click on here, you can see that I loaded Coaster. The way that I did that was I downloaded the font from the font, and all you got to do is hit load font, come in here, find that folder that downloaded from the font, and pick it. So I'm going to do the shadow one now. I did the other one. So let's see. I'll hit open. And let's see if I can find the shadow one. Now all I have to do is come in here and type in Coaster, and you can see the shadow one loaded now. And I can use that. Look at that. Super easy. So if you have a font that you have on your desktop, you can find that as well, and you can just use it in Procreate. But if you don't want to do that, if you have Canva, for example, and you can't download the fonts, let me show you how to do it. This will work the same with Affinity Designer, and that is saving a PNG file of something that you want and then uploading it here. So here I am on Canva. We're going to do this really quick. I'm just going to click here on text, and you'll notice there's some things that font combinations that they have already done. You can type your own text. This will work the same way, but I'm just going to pick one here. Let's do sale, 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 and make this bigger. Let's say you have a special font that you want or a special color that you want on here, and you typed it out, and there you go, sale, sale, sale. We're going to export this and download this here. Doesn't have to be a transparent background, although if you have that, that would be really great because you can knock out the background in Photopea as well. But I'm going to do transparent background, and I'm going to download this as a PNG file. So here we go. And it's downloading here to my desktop. I'm going to go back to Photopea and upload that to Photopea, or just drag it in. You can do the same. So first, I'm going to get rid of this. So now I'm in Photopea. I'm going to drag in that design. And there you go, sale, sale, sale. And we can do the same thing on here. So if we do, instead of text though, because this isn't text, we'll have to go to edit and transform, and warp is right here as well. And you can see we have the same things right here. So if we do wave, you can see we have handles here now too. So we can move some of this stuff up and down, and you can just play with it. You can see it warps it automatically for you, and if you want to play around with it, you can. So real simple way to do that. You can move things around, like I said. Not as cool as the text, in my opinion, but you still have the option to do this. So if you really want to do it and you have the right text in Photopea, I would just do the text one because then it's editable. You can see you can't edit this because this is a PNG, but you can still warp it. So if you do all your designs in Affinity Designer or Canva, you can bring it in here as a PNG and start using some of these custom warp features right here. It's just an edit, and you have the same thing. The only difference is you have handles here instead of the bars that you can pull back and forth, but same kind of effects, same kinds of things. You could do an arch, you could do a fish, you could do any of these. Play around with this. Super powerful, and I think it can really help you, especially if you're doing maybe athletic designs with the arch, or you're doing vintage retro designs with the wavy things. These can be really helpful for you, and you don't have to figure out how to do it in Affinity Designer with moving the points. It just does it for you. And you can just use these handles and move things around. And once you have it, you can hit check. Yes, I like it like this. And now you can see I have a warp. So have fun with this. Hopefully this was really helpful for you. Play around with it. It's gonna take some time to get used to and how it all works, but it's there and it's free. So use different fonts and use different things to make your design stand out. So that is it for this video. Thanks so much for watching. If this video is super helpful for you, make sure to give it a thumbs up. And if you're not subscribed to this channel already, hit that subscribe button right there. The question of the day is, have you heard of this warping feature in Photopea before? If this is the first time you've heard about it, let me know in the comments. If you've heard about it before, let me know how you used it and how you like it and what setting is the best for you. Love to hear that as well. Thanks again for watching. And if you want to see more design tips, click on these videos right here. And as always, guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one. Bye.